So I'm out this morning to try and fix this storage heater. I've already been out here once, so I know what the problem is, but I'm just going to go through some of the things that hopefully it might help people in the future. So straight away, isolated there, but it's also on economy 7, so it only comes on at night time. Yeah, I think it's a Creed storage heater, so if you look underneath, you'll see two little screws, one being there and the other one being just over there. First of all, we need to undo those. So once you undo those two screws, at the bottom, the front cover just lifts off, and then you're faced with this panel here. Now at the moment, I can touch it there and it's really quite cold, but if I touch it along here, the temperature difference is massive. So at the moment, the element here, I've removed it because it was a faulty element. But to remove this cover, there's just a couple of the outside screws that we need to take off. So we've got this panel off now, and we've got the storage heater bricks on show, as you can see. So we've got four sets. That means that we've got four sets of elements. And again, just got a little sort of temperature gun. So I know this element was the faulty element anyway. I've already done the diagnosis last week. But either way, at the moment, the element's not here. So when I got to the storage heater, this is how it was. And again, it's isolated there. It's on an off-peak supply anyway. So what I did, I quickly undone that. I put it on a 13-amp plug to get it all back live again. And so if you look underneath here, you can see that's where the elements all connect into. And so when I was doing the fault diagnosis, the first thing I checked was that there was 230 volts at each element, and there was. I sort of had my ideas that this element under here was the faulty element because it was cold. And so one of the things that you can always use is a little thermometer like this. So again, if I just measure the temperature of the bricks there, that's reading about 84 degrees, which is obviously quite a lot. But as I move over to the elements that I know that I work in, it soon goes up. So obviously that's reading 250 degrees there, and it's reading 162 there, and 119 there, and then obviously just 89, 88 there. So either way, I know this is the faulty element because I've checked the other elements and they are all working. But obviously sometimes the heat is moving down to the coldest spot, but that should all be a nice even temperature all the way across. Obviously the element's not there because I've removed it last week. I'm just gonna recheck this element as well because that was quite a low temperature. So we'll check that and I'll show you how I check it to make sure that it's working okay. Okay, so the element is in place. You can see where it is. So just talking about how these storage heaters work is basically the element obviously heats up and it's surrounded by bricks, which is then surrounded by insulation. The idea of these is that they're called nighttime storage heaters. The element heats up at nighttime on the cheaper electricity. It heats the bricks up, which are very dense material. They hold the heat really well. And during the day, the idea is that they are still hot. And just talking about a couple of the other functions, on the top here, we've got the control there, which is for the thermostat. And then this control here is for the boost function. And so what the boost function is, it lifts this little flap up. So if we operate that boost function, it will lift this flap up here. And what that does there is that allows the heat to come out of that gap. So normally it should be left closed. But what people often do, they turn the boost function to maximum, which then opens this. And so the idea of that is that in the evening, if you want a little bit of extra heat, you can open the boost function, which will then allow some of the heat that's being stored in here to come out and come out into the room. But what you must remember to do is at the end of the evening, before you go to bed, is to close that off. If we look at the element there, I'm just gonna show you some of the fault diagnosis on the elements, how to find out whether they are faulty or not. Okay, so I've just probed on to the bottom of the elements there, as you can see, and the resistance of that element is showing at 64.1 ohms. Now, if I measure all three elements, that will all read the same. Now, when the faulty element was in here, that also read the same resistance, because all I'm doing, when this element was in place, this also read a nice, low, acceptable reading, even though if I took the element out, it was reading 999 ohms, which is obviously maximum resistance. And the reason because of that is that it's simply you've got four resistors here in parallel. So later on, I'll draw a picture and we'll do some calculations to sort of show the resistance in parallel. The rule that we always know, the overall resistance resistance of the circuit will be less than the lowest resistance. So even though we had 999 ohms, these three elements are reading a normal resistance, so it's always going to be lower than the lowest resistance. So even though this was a faulty element, I'm not going to pick anything up at all by taking the reading from below there. I've been told before that's how you fault find when you're doing elements like this, and it really isn't. You have to remove the element to measure what the resistance is. So all I'm doing now is this is the actual faulty element that I took out, and as you can see, I'm measuring the resistance of it, and that's reading 999 ohms. That shows that that is the faulty element, because there's no path through it for the electricity to flow. When it was in situ, I'm not actually measuring the resistance of the element, I'm measuring the resistance of the circuit. Just while I've got this second one exposed, I am just going to check the resistance of that one as well, just to make sure that is okay. So again, that's the second element. Now, I never checked that one previously, but I did have suspicion that that was faulty. The reason I didn't check it, because I knew that I was going to come back here and take it apart again. So as you can see there, that's also reading 999 ohms. So again, I'll check the others and see what they're like, but because of the temperature of the bricks was so much more that side, I think they'll be okay, but I will just check. Okay, so this is one of the spare elements that I've brought with me today, and so we know that we've got two faulty elements down there. I've checked the elements on this side, they're both okay. This is a good element that I'm going to put in, and the resistance of that is reading 71 ohms, 72, 73 ohms, whatever they are. And so we know that that's a good element, so that's the one that I'm going to put in. Again, remember these are wired up in parallel with each other, and so this has got a set resistance of 72 ohms. So now what we'll do is when I get home, I'll do another video and I'm going to draw out a circuit, doing a parallel circuit, and just explain again the importance of understanding parallel circuits when you're at college and how it is sort of being applied in the real world. Okay, so what I'm doing now is I'm just going to probe onto anywhere, and that's measuring the overall resistance of the circuit, which is interesting, that's 17.4 ohms. Okay, so I can check the resistance anywhere on that circuit, and because these are in parallel, anywhere I check the resistance, it's measuring the overall resistance of the circuit. Okay, so the storage heater's all put back together now. We'll turn the switch on for so that it comes on tonight, and again, that's all working. Another way, when you are doing fault finding, you can also use the clamp on ammeter and you can work out what the current is going through the circuit. Obviously, if the elements are faulty, there will not enough current will be going through. So again, but that's not something that we're going to do today. But again, hopefully that should all come on and be working tonight.